सुपर मैश एनालिसिस ऑफ द सर्किट. सो टू सॉल्व सर्किट विद द हेल्प ऑफ KVL, KCL, नोड एनालिसिस, मैश एनालिसिस, दिस मेथड्स कैन बी यूज. सो समटाइम्स इट विल हैपन दैट कंडीशंस इन द सर्किट आर नॉट मैचिंग और नॉट अप टू द मार्क टू अप्लाई दिस मेथड्स. इन सच केसेस वी हैव टू यूज सुपर मैश एनालिसिस ऑफ द सर्किट. सो टुडे वील सी व्हाट आर द स्टेप्स टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम और टू फाइंड आउट द अननोन वैल्यूज विद द हेल्प ऑफ सुपर मैश एनालिसिस. लर्निंग आउटकम. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई सुपर मैश एनालिसिस टू फाइंड अननोन करंट्स. यस. So, to study the super mesh analysis, we have to consider a simple circuit, or we have to take a example of a circuit in which the condition will arise so that it is required to apply super mesh analysis instead of mesh analysis. Yes. So, generally in mesh analysis, we'll apply KVL to the loops. Okay. And after solving the equations, you can find out the value of unknown currents. But in the example circuit sample, you can see here that between these two loops, okay, there comes a branch which consists of current source. Yes. If such condition will arise, it is not possible to solve the problem with the help of mesh analysis. In such cases, we'll go for super mesh analysis, okay, and we'll find out the unknown currents. So now we'll see the steps to solve the problem with the help of super mesh analysis. So first step is find total number of mesh for a given circuit. Okay, so we have to find out number of mesh present in a given circuit. So in the given circuit there are total three loops or mesh. Loop number one, this is loop number two, and outer loop, this is the third loop. Yes. So from these three loops, if you apply mesh analysis to the two loops in a general method, you can easily find out the unknown value of current. But here a common branch consists of current source is there, so you can't apply mesh analysis. Okay. Second step, write KVL equation for mesh. Okay. So instead of applying mesh analysis to these two loops, for the outer loop you have to write down KVL equation. Okay. And inside super mesh we have to apply KCL. So for these two loops, the branch which is common will consist of current source. So for this particular portion, we have to apply KCL, or we have to write KCL equation. And after solving those equations, you can find out mesh currents or unknown currents. Is it? So we'll take one problem statement and we'll try to solve it. So this is the problem statement, okay, and we have to find out loop currents. Okay, so we assign, or I will assign loop currents as current I1, loop current I2, and loop current I3. You can observe this branch is common between loop 1 and 2. There is a resistor of 1 ohm. Between loop 2 and loop 3, there exists a resistor of 1 ohm. But between loop 1 and loop 3, there exists a current source of 1 ampere. So you can't apply mesh analysis directly. Instead of that, we have to go for super mesh. So what we are going to do is, we'll apply mesh analysis to the loop 2, mesh analysis to the loop 2, and we'll apply a mesh analysis to combining loop 1 and loop 3. Okay, by combining loop 1 and loop 3, we'll apply mesh analysis, and inside the super mesh will apply KCL. Okay, so we'll solve this. So I will just draw the portions where we are going to apply mesh analysis, or I will redraw the circuit once again so it is good for you to understand. One ohm, 1 ohm, resistor of 1 ohm, current source 1 ampere, voltage source 1 volt, loop 1, loop 2, and loop 3. What I do is, while applying mesh analysis, it is required to assign the terminals of voltages to the resistors. So according to loop 1, I am assigning the terminals of the voltages to the resistors. Okay, according to loop 2, these are the terminals of voltages for resistors, and for loop 3, plus minus plus minus. Yes, what rule we are using to assign the terminals to the voltages across resistors? Current entering the resistor, the terminal is positive, and current leaving the terminal of resistor, the terminal is negative. For example, current I3 is entering to this part of the resistor, so voltage terminal is positive, and leaving from this terminal of the resistor, so it is negative. Okay, I have assigned the terminal to the voltages. Okay, now apply KVL to the loop 2. Okay, I have to apply KVL to the loop 2. Resistor of 1 ohm is common between loop 1 and 2. So while writing the voltage across this, okay, what we have to do is we have to add or subtract the currents. Okay, if direction of currents are same, we have to add it. If direction of currents are opposite, then we have to subtract it. So here direction of current I1 and I2 is opposite, so we have to subtract the current. And how subtraction is to be done, what method or what assumption we have to do is, to which loop you are applying the KVL, that loop current is greater than the remaining currents. Okay, so voltage across 1 ohm, I will write it as a minus 1 into I2 minus I1. For loop 2, there are 3 resistors, 1, 2, and 3. So we have to add the voltages across these resistors. So first term is this minus 1 into I2 minus I1, minus 1 into I2, minus 1 into I2, and for this particular resistor, this resistor is common between loop 2 and 3, so minus 1 into I2 minus I3 equal to 0. Next, apply KVL to the combined loops 1 and 3. I will draw the portion of that here. See, this is the portion. 1 ohm, 1 ohm, 1 ohm, plus minus 1 volt, and we have to show the terminals of voltages also. This resistor is a part of loop 1, this resistor is part of loop 3, and this resistor is also part of loop 3. Okay. So KVL equation is 1 minus this 1 into I1 minus I2, because this resistor is common between loop 1 and 2. Here minus 1 into I3 minus I2, this resistor is common between loop 3 and 2, and here it is minus 1 into I3 equal to 0. Okay, yes. And inside super mesh you have to apply KCL. So this portion of the circuit, this portion of the circuit, it's inside the super mesh. So we have to write KCL equation. If you check the direction of this current source, direction of current I1 and direction of current I3, direction of current I1 is similar to direction of current source, and direction of current I3 is opposite to the direction of current source. So applying KCL inside super mesh, equation is I1 minus I3 is equal to 1. Okay, now make this as a equation 1, this as a equation 2, and this as a equation 3. Okay, solving equations 1, 2 and 3, you can find out values of current I1, I2 and I3. Okay, and values are 7 by 5 amps, 3 by 5 amps, and 2 by 5 amps. Okay, so while preparing this video lecture, I have used circuit theory analysis and synthesis by A. Chakravarti, Dhanpatraya publication, 6th edition. Thank you.